Hey everyone, welcome back to the episodes of the Anxiety and Depression Vlogs. This week I'm joined by my friend Alexis, who is going to help me talk about my new book, Coping with Anxiety and Depression, There Is Hope.
Yes.
Coping with Anxiety and Depression, There Is Hope.
Okay. So, throughout this book, what was your purpose behind writing Coping with Anxiety and Depression?
Coming from someone who has anxiety and depression, looking back on it, when I was going through it at my like worst time, right in the very beginning when I didn't know anything about it, I wish someone would have wrote a little step-by-step book of things that you're gonna experience when you're going through this. And you know, I checked out a lot of books when I was going through it, but they were all written by doctors and they were telling you the scientific and medical side of things, but they didn't share with you the personal side of things, of how your day-to-day life will change and how to cope with the things that are going to be different than what most people have to do in a day-to-day life.
Interesting. So now you describing that, so you're saying how doctors obviously write other books about anxiety and depression, coming from the writer himself and someone who went through that, what is the, you know, can you describe like what you see, like what's your perspective on depression and anxiety?
The way I see it is most people, when they hear depression or anxiety, it's a subject that isn't talked about often in today's society because it's something that is not really a light subject. It's pretty deep and a lot of people don't know how to go about talking about it because they're not educated in it. And my goal with this book is to educate those who either have it and don't have it, to let them know like a little insight on what it's like for a person who actually lives a day-to-day life with those issues.
Can you give me like some examples of like what you would feel or like what things you would go through when you're facing depression or anxiety?
Yeah, things that you go through when you're facing depression or anxiety would have to do a lot with like, you know, when I was in like my really low points, I would love and could have slept all day if I wanted to. You know, there was a lot of things, like I didn't like to socialize a lot. I wanted to be secluded in my room where it was like, that was my safe zone. And I didn't really want to go out. I didn't want to talk to friends. I didn't want to pursue relationships with others. I just wanted to basically look forward to going to sleep that same night. Like that's what I looked forward to. And that I realized was just a crappy way to live. And so then figuring out how to change those thoughts of not wanting to do anything all day turned into motivation of, okay, how can we make my life better? Best way to combat these issues with other things other than just medicine, but like things that you can change within your day-to-day life.
Like lifestyle, the natural thing. Mm-hmm. That's good.
I know in chapter 5 you mentioned finding your passion. So throughout this journey, obviously when you figure that stuff out, I know you have an album out, you play guitar. Mm-hmm. Was it through this coping period that you discovered that passion, or was it...
Was that like another mechanism of coming over here?
You have to understand, when you're so in like a depressive state, there feels like no amount of words you can say will ever describe the pain that you're feeling. Mm-hmm. So when I play guitar, I just let out everything that I didn't know how to say verbally and put that to use through my passions. So I would say if you're someone who doesn't know your passions, try and think about what you spend money on a lot. What consumes your mind? So things like that are different questions that you can ask yourself on how to find your passion if you currently don't have one. And if you do have a passion that you really love, I recommend going 110% all into that, because I mean, that's gonna keep you going and it's gonna keep your mind from wandering into those depressive states.
As you writing this book, was there any moments, or not writing the book, but coping with depression and anxiety, was there any moments where like, when is this gonna stop?
You right.
Know, stuff like that.
Yeah, when I was writing it, there were times where I thought, I don't know how long I'm gonna have this, but the way I view it as like, if I have this the rest of my life, then I better figure out how to manage it. And that's the important part of the message, I think, is regardless if you have it for a limited period of time or an extended period of time, mm-hmm. you have to learn to cope with it no matter what. So focusing on if you're gonna have it for the rest of your life doesn't matter, because if you know how to cope with it, then everything's gonna be fine either way. So I think regardless of the length of time, you should figure out on how to fix one day at a time. You know, everything is one day at a time, especially with this, because it's like each day could be totally different. You could wake up feeling great one day, and then the next day you want to stay in bed all day. So it all depends day to day, like how your situation is going and how you're gonna feel.
So, because it's depression and anxiety, I know they're two different, you know, different meanings. What would you categorize these out? Were you more depressed, or were you more having more anxiety, or was it just a combination of two of these?
I would say it was a combination of both, and what I've noticed is when my depression got really low, my anxiety was also really high. And my anxiety got lower when my depression lowered. So it kind of goes hand in hand with each other.
So then it kind of like balanced out.
Yeah, so now I would say I still get anxiety. I still have days where I feel more depressed than others, but when in times where it's really bad, I know the strategies that work for me, and that I also say in the book that when I'm feeling out of control and like it, where it's too much, then that's when I go to the techniques and stuff that I wrote down in the book. So
now getting to that part in your book, because I do know you wrote tips and techniques. So mm-hmm. if you can give anyone reading this book or anyone watching this interview, what are like two main ones that are like tips and techniques you would give them, or like your top three?
Top three would probably be find someone that you can talk to consistently about everything, about all of this, about how you feel.
Yeah.
Find someone to be your mentor, your guide, someone to help you out if you ever need anyone to talk to, because chances are you will. And second tip I would give is probably find a passion. Find something that excites you in life. And if nothing excites you, it's just because you're looking in the wrong places, I feel like. Because everyone does have a passion deep down. You just gotta find it, you know?
It's about you finding the passion and knowing what to do with that passion.
Exactly. And the third thing I would think would be to do your research and don't give up, because the more you research and the more you know, the more ways you're gonna figure out what works for you on how to cope, especially when it comes to depression and anxiety.
And then just a couple more questions. Mm-hmm. I know, like you mentioned, a part, a chapter from parents' perspective. How did your parents deal with it? Like, what was their perspective on it? Like.
Yeah, that's a really good question. I didn't know how they were gonna take it at first, because it was something that I hid it really well up until maybe like a week before I had actually told them, and then they started noticing I was getting a little more down, and then they asked me what was wrong, and then I sat them down and we had like a 45 to an hour long talk, and they responded really well. They were really supportive, and they're more supportive than I thought they were going to be. And I think that is a problem with a lot of people today, is they think their parents are going to give them a worse reaction than they really are.
And I think that's one of the reasons why they don't find that person, and especially their parents coming from a parent's perspective, is that they already think that, so they don't want to like make that acknowledgement. And I think.
Right.
I think having your parents support in it is like mm-hmm. will help you boost you up, you know.
Exactly.
And I think that's the number one key, is having your parents, you know, yeah. obviously support behind it, which is good.
Yeah, because I never would have gotten through it without the support of my parents, or friends or family. I mean, support system, that's probably the key thing right there. Have a support system. Find the people who care about you most and who you care about the most, and confide in them about these issues, so that when you do have another hard time in the future, it's easy for you to go to them and talk about it, you know?
Right.
Rather than if you don't talk about it and then you're dealing with something later on that's super difficult, it's gonna be more of a shock to them when you bring it up, rather than if you tell them first, talk about it with them and have them understand where you're coming from.
Right.
And then when you tell them, they're gonna be more understanding.
Even though it's hard for you to explain what you're going through, but you know, still them getting the glimpse of like, okay, I'm going through this,
exactly.
And them supporting you, I think that's really great. And then lastly, because I know it's there is hope. Mm-hmm. So what would you define like there is hope? That's
there is a way out. There is something that you can do to make your life better. When it comes to finding out how to cope with something as deep and as serious as anxiety and depression, there's a lot of different things that you could do, but I recommend before you just immediately hop on antidepressants or anti-anxiety medications, do your research of what you can do and change within your daily routine to first make an impact on your life. And then if that works but is not working to the 100% that you feel like it, then you could talk about medications. But first, I think it all starts with your just daily routine and changing the simple things that can make your life 100 times better.
And that's good, because that actually brings up my next question. So I mean, a lot of people, you know, take pharmaceuticals or they do like the natural remedy. What were some of the things you did? Was there like all natural? Were you ever on antidepressants?
The thing that I realize most about, whether it's antidepressants, anti-anxiety, natural supplements, your body is always going to be changing. And so that means your medicine is always going to be changing. You might take medicine for a year and it'll work great, and then out of nowhere you'll start to see the medicine not work within a very like short period of time, like a week you'll just be off. And then usually that means it's time for you to adjust your medicine in some way. Something's not working with your body. So I went through different changes. I mean, it took me a whole year of trying different natural supplements to different anti-anxiety, antidepressants. But once I did find it, I found that I could stick with that for as up until now. I mean, I found what works for me. But if you have to keep changing medicine, that's my one thing is don't give up, because most people try a medicine and if it doesn't work, they completely avoid it and they're like, no, I tried it, it doesn't work. No, they only tried one medicine. There's multiple different that work for everyone. So I would say don't give up and try and see what suits you, because one thing might not work for another person as it does with
you. Right, and that's very true. We're all different, we're all made different. So.
Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. If you guys like this video, please leave us a thumbs up and subscribe down below for our latest videos.